Hello friends, good morning. In this video, what we will do is we'll see how to install and configure 2008R2 server. I guess I have done this installation already, and I just need to configure a couple of shares, and then I'll need to add the server into the domain controller. So I will see those steps today in this video. So let me log into the server first. Okay, it's a legacy file server. Let me open console. If you see the IP, it's just taking. So I need to assign the IP first. The password. Okay. So assign the IP. CPL. Okay, properties. So VLAN 40, right? 192.168.40.2 I have given to DC, 3 I have given to SMS server. This will be 4. What 1 is? Dot one is gateway, and what is the DC? 2.168.40.2, right? So just click OK. Click OK. Close. Then connected. Go to firewall. Okay, so what is next step? I need to add the server into a domain. So let me add into the domain, change settings. I need to change the server name as well in order to add into the domain. Legacy file server. What is the domain name? This time I need to make sure the domain name. In the last video I confused on it. So the password, which you have the permission to add the server into domain. Okay, let me try once again. So why is that it? Not sure. Why it is taking so much of time. Okay. Right. Let me do one thing. Before that, properties, mode settings, remote settings. So let me restart. I'm sorry, yeah. Okay. Let's let it reboot. Server is up and running. Now I need to log into the server. Just RDP. Sorry. 192.168.40.3. This is the right server, right? What? 40.4, I'm sorry. 3 is. Okay. So 192.168.40.2/administrator because my laptop does, otherwise I can say maverick cloud.com/administrator. Right, we'll be able to log in. Now in the file server, so I don't have any extra share, so what I'll do, I'll go to edit settings. Come on, okay, I'll have to take some time. Happen, might be lost connectivity. Let's see. Yeah, lost the connectivity. There you go. Summarize that again. So edit settings. Or else I need to close this. Yeah, here it is. So let me create a 10 GB share. So how to do that? Let me add an additional volume, and that will be acting as a D drive. And then I'll go and create some folders inside the D drive, and then I'll share them over the network. So that acts as my file server. That's the plan. Okay. So next, take 10 GB. Right, done. Okay, so then let me go to administrator tools. What is disk management? Data management, disk management. So I have 10 GB, it'll bring online, then initialize, MBR is fine, simple volume, okay, drive, finish. Okay, there you go, E drive. So what I'll do is, to give that two big naming conventions, public folder, and then right. Kind of 2, 3, 4 file shares. So what I'll do is I'll go here, and then where it is, shares and all. Let me go to computer management, shares. New share, next, file server, D drive, public, okay, right, this is the, and share name, okay. Okay, then I can get the users and stuff, I can get the groups, but for now I'll have read only access. Right, this is one share, and the second share is, I'm sorry, on the E drive, generic share, next. The default permission is read only for everyone. Okay. Get one more. Support operations. If I say I should get it, yeah, all right. So this is how you can create the shares on a file server, and obviously the permissions are required in order to create the permissions. So I need to create some groups. Where I can create the groups, I need to log in into the domain controller. Sorry. Yes, two. There you go. Okay. So, let's see that I must see. Expand, use, and groups. I create a new group. New group. What is the group name? Segments, and then create a user. Now, I'll just remove it. Okay. Okay. So, password. added. So I've created two users and I'll add them into the group. And so let me go to the server. Management, okay, users and groups, groups, administrator, okay, and also, again. Users. The group is already added, right? So I'll go to this drive properties. Okay, and then security, edit, add. Admins, I'll give full control on this drive. Okay, and then I'll go to computer management, shares, properties, share permissions, add. Right, this is how we give control for a specific group of users. Right, generic. So what I need to do, I need to put some data on each folder and see if this data can be consolidated using the file server service, or sorry, SMS service, server migration service, which we're going to build in the next couple of sessions. And then we'll schedule a job to migrate the data from this legacy server onto Windows 2019 server. So these are the few other steps that we need to continue with. I'll stop this video here. So I'll go back. Let's say the file server steps are now completed. Save it. So I'm still left with a couple of other videos, so keep watching this section for entire series. Okay, thank you.